हेलो एवरीबॉडी, माय सेल्फ राकेश संजीव श्रीवास्तव, साइंस के जरिए संत माइकल इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ वीडियो एट लीस्ट द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास नाइन एंड द चैप्टर विल बी व्हाई डू वी फॉल एंड आल्सो चैप्टर नंबर 13. दिस इज अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड आल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट चैप्टर बिकॉज द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर It also most important. Why do we fall asleep? And also this chapter related to our body and our health. So this is most important part of the biology. And we should try to learn with patience and also try to improve our knowledge about our body and also different types of things. So in this chapter we are studying one by one each and every factor related to our health and also different types of diseases, their causes and their remedies and precautions, all are included in this chapter. So in this study we are studying why do we fall ill. It means our body and also our body related to health. Health is an important factor for our body. And also another factor is disease. Ill person. Or disease. Different types of disease occurs in our body. And also they show that about our poor health. And also some topics related to disease tree. So various types of factors related to this chapter. Now we will start. What is health? We all know about what is health. It is said that we have no any types of disease. Then it is said that we are healthy and also called healthy person. But it is not completely right. Everybody says that if we have no any type of disease, we are called healthy person. But this is not 100% correct. Good health or healthy person means a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being. A person who is completely mentally fit and socially fit, they are called healthy person. Now another definition of it. One should feel good physically, mentally and socially. They are called healthy person and this is called good health. Good health means the person who is physically, mentally and socially fit, they are called healthy person and also indicate our good health. Now, some factors related to good health. Before him, there are three terms here, physical, mental and social. What are the meaning of three topics, physical, mental and social? At first, physical. Physical means our body organs and our body parts, all are fit and also well functioning. When our all the body parts and organs do better work or run smoothly, then we say that we are physically fit. Second, mentally. We all disturb by mental. Various types of topics and disturbance also affected our mind and we all are sometimes not mentally well. So, if we are free from any types of tension and also any types of thinking, then it is called mentally free person. And socially fit. Everybody live in society and also society is the base in which everybody arises and also develops. So there are various types of factors related to social or society. If any types of tension are known, have any person, and also socially fit. They are called socially fit person. They are known in types of body and tension from your society and from your locality. Then they are called socially fit person. So the complete definition of health is the person who has no any types of physical tension, mentally pressure, and also socially problems. Then they are called healthy person. And also this is the indication of good health. Now factors, various types of factors affect our health. They are first social environment. We all live in which type of environment? Our society, what is the quality of our society and which type of person live in our society, which all are affected our health. Second, public cleanliness. Public cleanliness means sanitation of the different types of waste material scattered here and there in our society. We all live in society. In our locality, various types of waste material also scattered here and there. Then they polluted our environment and every person affected by it, and also this is the indication of bad health. And the person could not become healthy when various types of waste is scattered here and there in their society. So they are related to public cleanliness. And also personal hygiene. Personal hygiene means a person also always keep us neat and clean, keep themselves neat and clean. Any person always try to keep neat and clean their body, and also proper cleanliness, and they live at the place, at home, always try to keep neat and clean their household and their body, and also their clothes and all things. So these types of cleanliness related to personal hygiene. If a person always becomes free from every types of bad things and also dirty clothes and also their body, always try to clean their body part, these are related to personal hygiene. And also these types of person always free from different types of disease, and also their health is also always. Now social equality. Social equality also affects our health. It means in a society various types of people living there. Some are rich, some are poor, and some are illiterate. So their quality and thinking and also attitude all are different. According to their thinking, they all do different types of jobs related to cleanliness. And also some people try to clean their surroundings, some are not, and some always try to spread waste material here and there. In this way, these types of inequality also produce bad things or polluted their surroundings. So social equality must be needed for good health, and also social equality also affected our. Next, good economic condition. If our economic condition is better and also good, then we can do better, and also always try to keep neat and clean our surroundings, and also keep fresh our surroundings. And also, these types of factors also affect our health. If our economic condition are good, then we can do better job, and also keep neat and clean our surroundings, and also they improve our health. Otherwise, we cannot do this, and our health also falling down day by day. Now, some other topics related to health and immunity. There are two topics, health and immunity. What are differences between them? In the first part, we all studied related to good health. It means a person physically, mentally, and socially fit. This is related to health or good health. So all types of problems removed by our body, then we are so that we are healthy person and our health is also good. So health related to physically, mentally and socially fit person, and this is claiming the person they have no any types of disease. One disease related to disease. Person they have no any types of disease. Then the person are called disease-free person but not called healthy person. These are differences between health and disease. Next topic related to this chapter, sign and symptom. What are differences between sign and symptom? First, we all try to understand with an example. Suppose some student or many students always go to school and there is no any type of problem they face any day. Then it is said that, and everybody said that, this person was healthy and they have no any types of disease and also healthy person. Suppose one person feels some uneasy, suppose weakness and also some pain in their body and also mental harassment, various types of bad moods or uneasy feelings occurs there. Then after one or two days, this person feel that something went wrong to their body, and also in this way, this person go to the physicians. And physicians also try to know what will happen with them. Then the person also try to understand or try to say to the physician that mental fit, unfitness, weakness and also some pain in their body. These types of some system they also share to the physicians. On the basis of these types of uneasy feelings, physician also try to say that the patient can do some types of test. And finally, on the basis of result of test, the physician say that this type of disease occurs the person. And also this person suffer from the particular types of disease, and this disease also related to which organs of their. And also, in this way, the patient try to know that they have these types of disease and accurate disease, exact recognition of the disease. So, symptoms are some unnatural things occurs to the patient. They are called symptoms. And on the basis of symptoms, when they also try to know which type of disease occurs, this is called sign. Sign means exact recognition of the disease of the patient, and symptom means different types of symptom, different types of uneasy feelings occurs to the patient. This is called symptom, and on the basis of symptom, we will try to know exact recognition of the disease in which part of the body. This is called sign. So this is also important topic, sign and symptom. After this, the next topic was acute and chronic disease. Acute disease, we have different types of disease occurs in the living body. Some disease occurs for very short period, and also they remove or free from these types of disease in few days. These types of disease are for acute disease. Acute disease means short term disease. And chronic disease, long-term disease. Acute disease related to short-term disease means this type of disease always occurs for a very short time of period. And chronic disease related to very complex disease, and also this disease also the patient suffers for a long time of period. These are differences between acute and chronic disease. And also in the next part of the video, we will study in details about acute and chronic disease. Common cold is a very simple disease related to acute disease. And also tuberculosis related to chronic disease. Now, next question was, what are the causes of disease? Disease occurs in our body and what are the causes of disease? So, various types of factors related to this disease, and for the disease, various types of factors are responsible. First, poor health. If a person has poor health, then various types of disease occur this person. Second, genetic disorder. Genetic disorders are the causes of different types of disease. Some diseases are genetic. It means this disease also spread from parent to their young ones. Now, various pollutants. Different types of pollutants present. Water pollution, air pollution, soil pollution, sound pollution. They also create various types of diseases. Now, improper functioning of body organs. When our body organs do not work properly in a proper way, then various types of disease occurs in our body. Next, poor economic condition. You all know that the poor person is a very worst person of the society, and also this is a curse to being a poor. And also, poor person have no capacity to fulfill their requirement, minimum requirement, and also they suffer from various types of disease. So, poor economic condition play important role in the different types of disease. These are some introduction related to the chapter why we all is. We all know about some important topics, and in the next part of video, we all study one by one steps forward during the book, and also we all study step by step according to syllabus this types of topics. So you all try to write notes on this chapter and always try to write and learn it. I complete this part. Thank you.